Hello everyone, good afternoon. Today we are going to start our next lecture. The topic name is pesticide formulation. So this topic is very important and it comes under in chemical control also. So in last lecture we already discussed on that chemical control, its classification and all this. So let's see in today lecture the formulation of insecticide. First of all, so the formulation of insecticide is nothing but some formulation are ready to use and were used in different purpose, and they are must be further again diluted with water, some different agent like petroleum based solvent, or and then after that used for the different purpose. So first of all, the pesticides or pesticide formulation is a mixture of active and inert, that means the inactive ingredients. And its definition of formulation of insecticide, it is nothing but it is a incorporation of pesticides into a suitable solvent. In fact, use in different carrier, and we can also use different supplementary agents or any type of the adjuvants. So during the application time, so this agents that required and known as a formulation. So what is the necessity or what is the purpose behind to prepare this type of the formulation? Because of this many pesticides or many like insecticide available, and they are pure form, and it is in very costly nature, and this formulation for the cheaper point of view, this necessity or to prepare this formulation. So it gives the cheaper and even also that to safe form of insecticide purpose. This is the first necessity. Second one, suppose in case the high concentration may also that to prove to be phytotoxic. Oh, okay. So that called as to cause any type of the hazards on plants. Okay. So next one, it's a distribution point of view. If this formulation or if we add any type of the ingredients, so that for easy distribution that on large area, and due to that require that very low volume formulation for the purpose, even also that pure material is a highly hazardous, and that's why its handling point of view, it is very dangerous. And this formulation also that decreases some residual hazards point of view. Again, lastly, to effectiveness purpose, that to improve the effectiveness purpose, this formulation is required. So these are the all this five necessity, and it is important for examination. Now the let's see the different types of formulation. So here liquid formulation and dry formulation are available in the market. So the liquid formulation are the EC, that's called as a emulsifiable concentrate, SL, that's solution, SC, it's called as a suspension concentrate, EW, that concentrate emulsion, ME, micro emulsion, some aerosols, that A, soluble liquid, that denoted as a SL, and a ULV, ultra low volume liquid, and oil dispersion. So these are the all these liquid formulation type of the pesticide available in the market, and same as like some solid form, that's a dry formulation also, that DP, dustable powder, wettable powder, soluble powder, water dispersible granules, that denoted WG, and lastly this granule, that G. So these are all that different types of formulation in exam. That question on that topic, the defined formulation and give its different types of formulation or enlist its type of formulation like that will ask. Okay, so now the next one, this firstly we discuss on this formulation of dry formulation. So this dry formulation, the firstly it's a dust, and in this formulation the toxicant is diluted either by mixing with or by the impregnation or any type of the carrier we are used. And this carrier may be in the form of the organic flour, like here mentioned as a walnut shell, okay, and some are the wood bark or any type of like pulverized mineral. Okay, now let's see, I'm highlighting here this pulverized mineral, sulfur that comes under this minerals are sulfur, lime, that gypsum, and any type of the tar. Or we can also use here in dust for preparation of preparation purpose of dust. This clay also that in this atapalgite, bentonite, and kaolins. So these are the all that some carrier use for the preparation of the dust formulation. And here that during the final product of this dust when prepared, here the toxicant or the mix or ranges here in this dust formulation 0.65 to 25% are toxicant here that added, and this particle size is very less. Okay, so that is near about less than 100 microns here that I mentioned 100 microns. Okay, so this is the particle size of the dust, and it is denoted by the D. And in market, this type of the formulation of the dust are the example of this pesticides, linden, malathion, that 5%, and the carbaryl. So this is the overall this dust formulation. It is very easy to that to remember this toxicant. It is in the diluted or prepared by the help of this carrier, and the which are this carrier were used, like this all this carrier there mentioned, and here that which what is the toxicant percentage here mentioned or ranges that here all these. So let's now the next one. So the wettable powder, or we can say here water dispersible powder, and this water dispersible powders also that powder formulation, and which is during the application time or during the spraying time, which is diluted with water and which gives this stable suspension after the diluted with water. And here the toxicant or active ingredient here same like dust formulation here ranges is 15% to 95% here mentioned or that to added, and it is formulated by blending with the toxicant and other some diluents such as like atapalgite, and this as a that this active agent and some other like auxiliary material also were added that commonly called as a sodium salt, and some stickers also which also added for the preparation of this type of the wettable powder. Here that in the slide the picture is I'm showing you, and then after that with this application or spraying, so that known as a this diluted form. Okay, so it is more effective than dust. Okay, and it is denoted by WP. Okay, that is called as the WP or water dispersible powder. Example of this formulation is carbaryl 50% of WP. Now the next see granules. These granules, it is in the granule formation of insecticide, and it is composed of or this is a different inert material like a carrier, some diluents like vermiculite or some other carrier also used, that's called as a vegetable carrier. And this granule formulation size ranges from, so here 250 to 1250 microns that available, and this formulation contains the toxicant ranges of this 2 to 10% were added in this granules. And this formulation is generally used for the control of weeds, different plant diseases, and some insect like nematodes, some snails, and some rodents purpose that this granule formation used. And it is denoted by here the G. And various formulations of this granule, the examples are the 4-8 10%, carbocuron 3%, quinolphos 5%. These are the available in the market in granule form. So now the next one, soluble powder. This soluble powder, which is also the similar with the wettable powder, but dissolved readily and forms a true solution. And these pesticides are composed with the water soluble diluents and other wetting and dispersing agent. Okay, an example of this pesticide formulation are the acephate 75, that SP. So now the next one, some different liquid formulation. So in previously I said this all dry formulation. Now the liquid formulation of this emulsifiable concentrate. This emulsifiable concentrate, this formulation contains the toxicant. As in the mix with here, the slide, the picture I'm showing you here, and this one, that diluted form. So this solvent of toxicant is act as a emulsifying agent. Okay, and this emulsifying agent, it is in a clear solution here. Okay, so this clear solution, which gives an emulsion of oil in water type, and when diluted with water, then we can use for the spraying purpose. Okay, and then at the time of the spraying, this solvent evaporates quickly and leaving only the deposit, and it is a toxicant from which water also evaporated. And this emulsifying agents are used generally and mixed with this liquid based formulation are alkaline soap, some organic amines, some carbohydrates, gums, lipids, and some proteins. In exam, the question arises on that emulsifying agent in case of this liquid formulation enlist, or that gives the example of emulsifying agents. So always remember, these are the alkaline soap, organic amines, carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and these liquid formulation are denoted by EC, that is the emulsifiable concentrate. And examples of this pesticide available in the market as a chlorypyrifos pesticide 20 EC, propinophos that 50 EC, here that mentioned EC, that 20% toxicant, and the pesticide name is chlorypyrifos. Okay, now the next one, solution, this denoted by SL, and this toxicant also that dissolved in organic solvent. Okay, and this such as this amyl acetate, organic solvent, which are these amyl acetate, carbon tetrachloride, ethylene dichloride, xylene, petroleum, and kerosene. So like in case of the emulsifiable concentrate, which are this emulsifying agent, and here in solution best formulation and prepared, so here use organic solvent, and which are these organic solvent, as amyl acetate, and this all this, and generally it is mostly used to control the, those are the pests comes under in household, that household pest, and some like aquatic insect like mosquito type pest, that controlled by this formulation. It is denoted by SL, and the pesticides available in the market as a the imidacloprid, the 17.8% SL. So here the pesticide formulation of this solution base. Now the next one, aerosols. This aerosol, this toxicant is suspended in the mixtures particles, and size ranges from the 0.1 to 50 microns in size, and in air. In air, when it acts or when spread, that as a fog or is as a mist. And this type of this pesticides that achieve two types, that action, that burning the toxicant with the heat. Second one, that the toxicant dissolve in the liquefied gas and to form a fog in air or a mist in air. And when it's released, the toxicant particle to float in the air with the rapid evaporation of the release the gas, and finally this pest and other organism that will killed by this type of the gas or this fog. Okay, and it is effective against those are the flying insect and the pest in dense foliage. So that time this type of the aerosols pesticide or formulation generally used. Example here mentioned, that aerosols bomb, that example available in the market. Now the, let's see some also the that in the gaseous forms, some formulation available, that's we can say, or we can talk them to fumigants. And it's a definition about this fumigants is any chemical compound or pesticide compound which is a volatile at ordinary temperature and sufficiently toxic is known as a fumigants. And generally it is used against those are the store grain pest commodity, some are the nematodes, some soil borne type of the pest or some organism that killed by this fumigant formulation. And in exam in market, the example of these pesticides are aluminium phosphate tablet, that generally used against the rats,
ethylene dibromide is used for the, some store grain, some ED ethylene dibromide of tetrachloroethane. Okay, some mixture are also that available to use as a fumigants. Okay, so same like the some adjuvants also, but these adjuvants are the, it's a supplementary agents that used in the pesticide during the application or during the that preparation. Okay, so it's a short note type question will ask in exam, and the definition is very important. The supplementary agents which do not contribute directly to the toxic, here the word is important, adjuvants is not a toxic substance, it is a one agent that gives or to further increase the effectiveness purpose. Okay, that the toxic the effect of pesticide, but are used for the improving physical condition of pesticide so that the pesticide become more effective in action, so called as adjuvant. Okay, so here the different types of adjuvants are available. So commonly called as a dust carrier, like organic flour, lime, gypsum, tar, kaolin and volcanic ash. Some solvents also that act as an adjuvant, that is amyl acetate, carbon tetrachloride, ethylene dichloride, xylene, petroleum, kerosene, tin oil. Some dispersing agents also some adjuvant, polypon H, blancol, dexot 21. Some emulsifying agents or emulsifiers that we already discussed in emulsifying concentrate pesticide formulation. Why? Because it is surface active agents. The principal function of these to modify the properties. Okay, so that they may be all the oil dispersion or wettable oil in water type that called as, or that water in oil type, that WO, the pesticidal emulsion are in oil in water type. An example of these, alkaline soaps, carbohydrates, proteins, organic amines, and some are the adjuvants also that the wetting and spreading agents also, and available in the soaps form, Tipol, Targites. Tipol is generally many times used against different pests that is added in pesticide. Tritonex, this is also the famous adjuvant. Some stickers also, like some detergent powder we can use, other sticky agents we can use for the to improve the or to increase the properties of the pesticide. Okay, so these are all these adjuvants. Okay, now the next one, very important, some two terminology that are generally used in formulation, pesticide formulation, that is a synergist and antagonistic. Very, very important. Why? Synergist means what? It is also the one chemical compound which by themselves are non-toxic or only slightly toxic, but when it mix with the pesticides compound, that immediately to increase their toxicity. Okay, called as synergist, that to increase the toxicity purpose those compound or chemical use, but these are all the non-toxic or maybe only slightly toxic, so called as a synergist. And this example of the synergist are sesamine, sulfoxide, piperonyl butoxide also. Here I mention only two example. And second terminology of this antagonistic, this antagonistic, it is nothing but it is also the one chemical compound, but when mixed together immediately to reduce the toxicity action after the mixture of two compound. So antagonistic means that to reduce the toxicity, okay, but synergist means that to improve the or increase the their toxicity, called as a antagonistic. So that is example that two terminology very important. Okay, so thank you. So this is overall this today's topic of our pesticide formulation. So thank you very much.